Hi, this is Vanessa from Envision.
And I'm Costanza. Hi, everyone.
Hi. Today, we're here to tell you all about a new feature coming on to Ally Everywhere called Shortcuts. And Shortcuts, as the name suggests, gives you a shortcut to the things you ask your Ally the most. And it saves you time and makes Ally work a little bit harder for you.
But what are exactly the shortcuts? So as you can see, we are in the preferences of our Ally and we can go to the new feature that is, again, shortcuts. Here you see that there's like a bunch of them. These are also mine, like a personal one, but what we prepared for you are the first four that you see here. So describe scene, scan text, weather check, and daily briefing. And really briefly, we can say that describe scene basically opens your camera and like describe what is in front of you. Scan text opens the camera again, but it this time reads the text and will tell it to you out loud, yeah, what is in front of you text-based. Then we have weather check, which just access your current location and tell you what's the weather like. And daily briefing is instead accessing to your calendar so it can help you navigating through the appointments that you have for the day or the day after. So once you have your shortcut, you can also customize the shortcuts other than add one. We can try to do one like really quickly so you see also what is inside the shortcut itself. Let's say that we want to edit the scribe scene. So as you can see here, briefly, we have the name. You can change the name. You can, yeah, do whatever. Also add icons. Maybe we can put a smiley face here. And then you can also choose both the mode and the ally that you want your shortcuts to have. So if you want to call Tom or message Tom, you can choose between the two options. I would stay with call Tom. And then you can also change the ally. So now I have Tom, but I can do Zoe, Leah, whatever. We're just going to stick with Leah and then go back. And then what you see here is what would your ally do, which basically means that you can describe the action that the shortcuts should do. In this case, it's taking a look and describing what's in front of me. I will leave it like that because that's what I think the scribe scene should do. And then you can see here that there are also two toggles that you can toggle on or off. So one is adding in the shortcuts directly to your home screen. So once you're editing or are you adding it, you can directly put it in your home screen on Ally. Or you can add it to Siri, which is also a new feature that we are launching with it. Then you can save it and just go back to your home screen. And you will see that it's there updated with a smiley face.
You know, it's all really cool with these shortcuts which are from Ally, right? Apple users will know that there's already a shortcuts app from Apple. Where you can go in and access all your shortcuts. So what we've done, which I think is really cool with our dev team, they've actually made our Ally shortcuts compatible with that app. So you go into your Apple shortcuts app and all your Ally shortcuts are there too. So it means you don't always have to be an Ally in the app to use your Ally shortcuts, which is very, very cool.
So how do we add a shortcut? Let's do that together. We are in the preferences of our Ally. We should go in shortcuts. And then as you can see at the bottom, we have add shortcuts. We can click on it. And as we said before, there's a list of things that we need to fill. So the first one would be the name. I don't know. I want to try to make my nonna speak English with some people. Let's say she's in Rome. She needs to speak English with some people. So we will call it translate. Oh, if English doesn't take something on me. Yeah. Okay. So we can choose a mode and we can choose an ally. We are going to stick with calling, but we can switch if we want to message in case it's needed. And with the ally, I have Leah selected. There are still the others that are available, but I'm going to stick with there. Then we should say what Ally should do. So in this case, we want Ally to translate what is being said to English. Then we want to add the shortcut to the start screen and we can save the changes. Once we save the changes, we see that everything is saved. And then we have also the toggle for adding the shortcuts to Siri, which we're going to do later if we want to. Now we can go back to the home screen and we see that right at the bottom of the home screen, there's our shortcuts translate. So let's put it at the stress test. We can click on it.
Wait for Ally to greet us.
Yeah.
Wait for her to talk.
So at least we know she's here. She's sure. There.
Please provide the text or speech you want me to translate into English.
Okay, what can my nonna say if she's in Rome speaking with an Englishman?
Well, he's bound to ask where the best pasta restaurant or pizza restaurant is, right? What do you think?
Per avere la miglior carbonara devi andare sul ristorante in fondo a destra. Let's see.
The translation of that sentence to English is to have the best carbonara, you have to go to the restaurant at the far right.
Yeah, well.
I'll take
your word
for it.
We don't know what it is, but yeah.
Thanks. So shortcuts really are a great time saver, and you can do virtually any kind of shortcut for, you know, for pretty much anything. The opportunities are endless. And the nice thing is you can go back, you can remove them, you can create new ones, you can edit them, you can improve them, change them depending on your situation. And as you use Ally more and get used to using Ally more, then it becomes more intuitive as well, right? Yeah. So one of my favorites that I use is one that creates for me automatically the headline news from the UK because I'm British, but I also live in the Netherlands, so I get the English and the Dutch headlines, which can be a long response, but that's really generally useful. Another one is, of course, the weather shortcut, which was fantastic, and the daily briefing, which takes me through what's in my calendar for the day. So you can use your Ally shortcuts wherever you use Ally, right? You can use it on your desktop, on your phone, on your Envision glasses. And of course, coming soon to the Ally Solos glasses, which I'm wearing currently on my face. But we're going to actually give my shortcut one I use every day. It's called Daily Briefing. It comes with Ally and it is going to look at my calendar and it's going to tell me what's going on in my calendar today. Now, I have this actually connected with my glasses, but for the sake of this video, we've connected it to the TV audio because it's easier to hear. So let's see what's going on in my life. Hopefully nothing too crazy so we can hear. So now I've just pressed that shortcut and of course I could ask my glasses for that shortcut as well when we're connected and it will then get Ally to wake up, start processing that information and it's a connection that the Ally has to make with my calendar. So it's using an AI to go in, check my calendar for today. Here's the answer.
Calendar for the last couple of days and you're busy Wednesday. Yesterday evening from 10 p.m. to 11 p.m., you had Dickie Vigar's birthday party. No location specified. So presumably a virtual toast or a quiet reflection.
It was.
Then on Wednesday, you hit the ground running, literally, with your early morning run alongside Bente at 5 a.m. to 6 a.m. over at Pelgrim Sport 11 in Leiden. That's a brisk start in a rather civilized spot, I must say. Following that, from 7 to 8 a.m., you have a small group functional session. Location not specified, but hopefully somewhere comfortable. Then from 8 a.m. to 9 a.m., there's the Envision Glasses demo via Google Meet with Augustine. A nice virtual engagement that aligns perfectly with your interest in accessibility and AI.
Of course.
Later, at 11:30 a.m. until 12:30 p.m., you're filming a shortcuts video alongside Amrith and Costanza, presumably something clever and productive. Come mid-afternoon, from 3 p.m. to 4 p.m., it's time for walkies with your Rhodesian Ridgebacks, Avi and Sia, followed by Kappa, Pure Bliss.
Okay, I'm going to actually just stop it there because my life isn't actually that interesting. I did add a special workout in the middle of the morning, which I didn't do. I did do the run though. Anyway, you can see that how incredibly helpful that is. You know, if I'm traveling to work, which I do every day, I commute and I can just hear as I'm even walking along, getting ready, just like anybody else. And when I'm low vision, it just saves me another reason not to have to scroll through a screen and read small text. So in any case, the world is open, you know, it's your only limit is your imagination. So go and try out shortcuts on Ally and share with us what you're creating shortcuts for because we'd love to hear about it. Thank you.